Hey guys, Tarek with Cyclone FPV. We're going to be doing some work on on Emax today, and we're going to put in a Ratel camera, and we are going to put in an XM Plus receiver. Let me straighten this out real quick. Okay, so with that said, let's get started on here. Trying to adjust this camera, and that should be good. My desk is really that messy, I guess. Okay, so let's get started here. I'm gonna go ahead and just remove the Fox ear wiring. Do that. Just a little bit. Get this in this to return back to the customer. There's a bag here. All right, so that goes back to the customer, and now let's get the new install done. Use the flex pen to get a little bit of flex to make sure it's working out on that area. Put some of my solder on there very quickly. Okay. Okay, that looks good. Get the ugly turn on. And then next thing, we're going to be putting an XM Plus, a new one. I don't know why. I don't remember what he said about this one not working properly, but he wanted it replaced. So I've got it sitting right here. We're basically going to swap it out. Let me just make sure I can get this one off. basically just going to try to heat up two pins at a time, first the outside and the inside, and tilt this back. Keep going. There we go. This way we can leave the pins intact. Now I'll just clean up the pins, the solder on the pins, and hopefully be able to use them. Okay. Only problem is when you do that, since they have solder on them, it may not be able to put this one back down, but we're going to see if we can. So let's get our flux pin. We're going to put that. Well, this is going to be interesting. This is already going to be too thick to fit this over, so let me see if I can remove it. We will try our best. I'm going to try to stand this up just at an angle so I can pull on the pins. And I guess I have a mounting board I could do that with. One second. I don't know why I'm not thinking of using that instead. Let me see where it is. Hey, babe, you know where that one board is? Where I can, it holds a circuit, it's blue. It's got the stands to put a circuit board on. I used to have it sitting around here. When I move stuff, I don't know where I put it. Oh, never mind, I see it. My bad. This will make it a little easier. So let me go this route. I don't know where I put it. By the way, guys, if you need any of these materials, we have them on our website. So feel free to stop on by if you need it. I haven't used this in a long time. It's kind of dusty. All right, so let's just get back to it. Spot. That's the only thing. You don't want to press this against anything that could break, so try to find an open spot that may work. Bottom of this board, that's going to hit the camera, so I can't do that. Let me put the bottom here, and let me see if I can just kind of angle it to the middle and skip the wires like that, maybe. That should work. Okay. Now, hopefully, I can get this done. So, let me heat it up here and pull on this side. There we go. This thing's hot. Yeah, that's alright. Clean that off. Try it again. Okay, one more and it's done. Yeah, alright. Now with that done, let's see what we got left.
Mm-hmm.
Babe, is there somebody there?
Oh, DHL. Thank you.
Oh, hey, brother. Thank you. Hey, you need water? Get him water, would you? We'll get you water. You want water?
Yeah, I was telling you,
he's out
here. Come on, get inside.
I was just, like, running away, man. I'm stopped by to see if the guy ready for me.
How you doing, brother?
I'm good, man, good. It's starting to pick up now, man.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now that it's Chinese holiday, great.
Yeah, it's all good.
There you are.
Appreciate it.
Hey, brother, have a good one.
Thank you.
Stay inside.
All right, there we go. So this is done. Now I'm going to go ahead. Just had to open those holes back up, so I use a push pin. Heat up the solder, use a push pin, send it through. Now we can go ahead and close this up. That should fit perfectly right here. Just like that, so that's going to be nice. All right, so let's just go ahead and get our flux pin. Put that needle back through so they're all even. There we go. We're in. Baby, do you need me?
I just had a question.
Yeah, what's up?
This is, I'm not crazy, right? Like, this is different.
What's that?
It's the same board, just they've changed it, right? Zeus 45?
This is a 4-in-1? 45. Yeah. The other one was a 35. Who's this for?
No, I'm asking. That's not what they looked like before, right?
No, right. They were black before.
Okay, I'm just
now they're red, but they're 45 amp now instead of 35.
No, there's a
there's a 35 also. 35. Yeah. So what they did is they made the red. The red indicates that it's a 20 millimeter setup, but it uses M3 screws. Did you say pause?
Yeah, I was saying like pause because this is what the 35 looks like now too, which I believe is.
It should be red. It's because that indicates that they now use M3 screws instead of M2s.
Okay, but still the same board.
Exact same board.
Okay.
Just make sure that we're done with the black ones first.
I will.
All right, guys. Now, I'm about ready to close this up. Sorry. So here we go. Okay. Let's get the receiver put on. Make sure that we're not in any way to hit anything and short it, and it's not. That looks great, actually. Fits perfect. So now I'm just going to come back over. Actually, let's put my flux pin again. Okay, and then here we go. Here's a little trick for you guys. If you're trying to solder these pins and you want that like Hershey Kiss looking solder where it goes down like it looks like a Hershey Kiss when it's done, put your solder on the base, right? And then just touch the top of it, right? Touch the top of the pin. The heat will make it drop like that, so then you won't have any problems. I'm just going to get this leveled out real quick. There we go. And then break that bridge up. And that is gorgeous. Everything is done. Everything is soldered. So now let's do a power-up test here. The only thing is I don't want the VTX. Oh, the VTX has been taken out. That's fine. So let me get my glasses out of the way. Make sure everything looks solid on this side too, and it does. So I'm going to go ahead and drop the glue right where I did my work here. Cover up all the work I did there. Okay. I'm also going to put it here. And I'm also going to put it underneath. All right. Now with that done, we will go ahead now. Plug this back in. Make sure those pins on the bottom line up, and they do. And so we want to make sure that we get power. I don't want to plug the... Well, I forgot the VTX is also hardwired in. Okay, so we may lose connection here the minute I do this. So as far as this goes, guys, it is done. I'm going to go ahead and do the Ratel real quick while you're watching because sometimes the VTX will be set on a frequency that will cut into our video. So let me just go ahead and finish this up real quick so you can see the end result at least. All right, so let's do that. his old receiver in here for him as well. Maybe he wants to keep it. Move that down as well, because that looks a little concerning to me. Alright, I'm gonna hold that on. I still gotta do a little bit of work on the board. I just want to put this on to make sure everything closed up properly. So now we're gonna test it, and then I gotta come back and put the nylon on and then put all the screws in. But I want to make sure the top fits, the camera is able to move. It does have full motion there, so we're good there. So now let's test and make sure. Now if we lose video, guys, I apologize. Like I said, the frequency of the VTX could interfere. So that's why I want to do this right now, at least give you guys, let you see it closed up before I finish. Now let me go ahead and get this done. Turn my monitor on to make sure I get camera. All right, I've got VTX. I think we are going to interrupt there. Receiver is on and powered with no problem. I'm going to go ahead now and scroll with the camera. It has not interrupted our VTX, so that's good. So I can show you guys what the camera looks like. Ready? So there it is on our monitor. There you go. So everything's working fine. So you can see that. So we're good. All right, so that's it. Now I'm just going to close it up, open it back up to put the nylon on, and then close it up for a final, and that'll wrap it up. So let me turn it off. We'll put my glasses back on so I can see everybody. Let's do this. There we go. Ooh. All right, guys. So that was a pretty quick little install there. I'm gonna go ahead and get this done real quickly. But I do want to let you guys know, if you have any questions, feel free to use our groups page on Facebook. You can always post in there for everybody to help, or you can find us on the website, cyclonefpv.com. And then always, I'd always appreciate if you'd follow us and subscribe to our YouTube channel. That would mean the most to me, okay? Other than that, guys, God bless, be safe, and as always, make sure to spend time with your family. You never know how much time you have left, so please make the most of it. There's always time to fly. Talk to you soon. Peace.